Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Recollection with you, Mr. Tim again. Okay guys, today I'm going to Fergana State University in order to take interview from native speaker, you know, and my dream is coming true. Okay guys, watch my video, don't forget to leave comments. How's it going?
Good.
You know, I wanted to take interview from you and I have some questions. Can you answer to them?
Sure, I'd be happy to.
Okay, the first one, I think a lot of guys really curious about knowing about you, you know, because some of them don't know about you anything. That's why, can you tell me about yourself something maybe?
Yeah, I'd be happy to. Okay. I'm Graham. I'm an English teacher at Fergana State University. Okay. I've been here for 9 months, almost 9.5 months now, living in Fergana. I come from the United States. I'm American. My hometown is Seattle, and it's in the state of Washington. And in America, there's two Washingtons. There's the capital, Washington, D.C., and then there's Washington State. And I'm from Washington State. Biggest city in Washington State is Seattle.
Okay, thank you. The second question is, what's your first impressions about Uzbekistan? You can say about maybe advantages, disadvantages. You know about this better because anyway you are foreigner, and it's better to. I mean, it's easy to express your feelings about our country.
Yeah, sure.
Maybe about education system.
Okay. One of my first impressions was that Uzbek people are really welcoming and hospitable. I got invited to lots of things when I first came. It was the fall, so it was wedding season. I went to lots of morning plovs and weddings, invited to people's houses. It was easy to make friends with Uzbek people, especially Uzbek men. Also, I noticed that there's a difference in our cultures in the way men and women interact. In my culture, it's normal for men and women to go out together, to eat meals together. But sure. In this culture, there's a bigger separation between the genders, men and women. At the university, at school, I think that one thing that's really holding Uzbek students back is their lack of access to technology. Sorry about that.
Okay.
Students need internet. Internet is vital for English education. And there's some websites in Uzbekistan that are hard to access.
Sure.
And that's hard to be a student of English and want a global citizen in that sort of technological environment.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. And the third question and the last one. What would you recommend to those people who are learning English? And they want to take IELTS, you know, and they are struggling about some kind of things. I'm struggling about reading and listening. What would you recommend?
I recommend if you want to get better at reading, it's really simple. You have to read more. Read everything and read anything that you think is interesting. And you can find all the things you need to read on the internet. The internet has books, the internet has articles, the internet has comic books. Anything you like to read and you think is interesting, read it. And for listening, same thing. Listen more. Listen to things that you think are interesting. Don't do things that are boring. If it's boring, you're not going to love it. If you don't love it, you're not going to do it. So YouTube is a really great resource for listening materials, and you can listen to English lessons produced on YouTube, or you can listen to authentic materials. I have a YouTube channel. You should check it out. If you Google Graham Derry, that's my name, GRAHAMDERRY, Fergana, you'll find my YouTube channel.
Okay,
and on
sweet.
That channel, I'm speaking in English, so listen to me.
Okay, thank you. And, you know, can you teach people have to be persistent, you know? I mean, I'm talking about students. Because, you know, when they just face to some difficulties, they just don't want to study. Maybe you know secret. It's not secret, but anyway, it's not magic. I know about this. But anyway, can you advise something? Maybe it's easier or
don't do something you don't like doing. If you don't like studying English, find something you like to study and go study that. You'll never be an expert at something you don't love. Find what you love and do that.
Okay, and the last question, I just wanted to ask this question, you know. Okay, what do you think about my channel? I created this channel in order to speak, in order to correct my mistakes. And what do you think, it is right way? I mean, it's efficient way to like improve my speaking or not?
Definitely, yeah. Creating a public, a public resource for your English speaking is a great way to improve your speaking, because when you're putting it out there on YouTube, you know lots of people are going to be watching it, so you're going to want to make it good. And then every time you put up a new video, then you'll see other people's videos and you'll learn something from their videos and you'll learn how to improve your own video. And so, yeah, you'll improve your English, you'll watch other people's English videos and learn from how they do it, you'll improve your video skills, and you can even make money on YouTube by selling advertisements if your channel gets popular enough.
Yeah. Thank you, Graham. I was really happy to take interview because it was my dream, you know, talking with a native speaker. And today my dream came true.
Oh, you're so kind.
No, I'm not kidding. It's real. And thank you that you agreed to meet with
you're
me
welcome,
and to
course.
Take, I mean, to give interview. Thank you.
Of course.
Oh my gosh, I did it, man. I did it. I could take interview from the native speaker. You know, I'm happy, guys. See you.